Hello friends, welcome to the fourth video on refrigeration and air conditioning. In the previous video, we have learned that the supply air condition is lying on the intersection of GSHF line and RSHF line. The GSHF line runs from the mixed air condition M up to the coil ADP. Hence, to fix the supply air condition, the knowledge of coil ADP as well as mixed air condition is required. In today's session, we will learn how to fix the coil ADP and mixed air condition with the help of ERSHF line. So here I have the same picture on which the room air condition and outside air design condition is plotted, which is generally known. You can calculate the RSHF by the ratio of room sensible heat and sum of room sensible heat plus room latent heat. Once you get this RSHF, you can plot this point of RSHF on the RSHF scale provided on the right hand side of the psychrometric chart and draw a line which is passing through the room air condition and this RSHF point, and you can extend it up to the saturation line. This line is called as RSHF line. This line intersects this saturation line at a point, but remember, this is not coil ADP. This is called as room ADP. Coil ADP, which is the minimum temperature of the surface of the cooling coil, should be lower than this because we are supplying the mixed air, which is a mixture of outside air as well as room air. So to dehumidify this outside air, lower temperature is required. To fix this coil ADP somewhere over here, we have to calculate the room sensible heat, effective room sensible heat, which is room sensible heat plus outside air sensible heat into bypass factor of the coil. Similarly, effective room latent heat is equal to room latent heat into outside air latent heat into bypass factor of the coil. Now here, bypass factor of the coil must be known, and we must be able to calculate this outside air sensible heat as well as outside air latent heat. So let us see how to calculate these two parameters. We have learned the formula of calculation of sensible heat as 0.0204 into volume flow rate, which is taken in CMM, that means meter cube per minute, into delta T. Now how this 0.0204 comes, I will try to explain on another sheet of paper. I don't want to create mess over here. So the sensible heat formula is basically the formula of m dot into Cp of the air, which is taken as average Cp into delta T, where mass flow rate is the multiplication of the volume flow rate, which is taken as CMM divided by 60 to convert this into meter cube per second. And the average density of the air is taken as 1.2, average density of the air, into the Cp average 1.022 kg per meter cube. So if you calculate these numbers, you will come to the figure 0.0204. So this formula is based on consideration that the average density of the air is 1.2 and average specific heat of the air in this range of the temperature is 1.022 kg per meter cube. The same formula can be used to calculate outside air sensible heat. So outside air sensible heat is equal to 0.0204 into cmm of outside air. The suffix O is used here for denoting the outside air condition. Now this outside air volume flow rate must be known to us into the temperature difference undergone by the outside air. So when the outside air comes inside the room, it undergoes the temperature difference, which is TO minus TR, because finally it comes to the room condition after rejecting heat to the room. So this is TO minus TR. So this is the formula to calculate OASH. Similarly, we have learned the formula to calculate latent heat, and which is 50 into cmm into delta omega. So this factor 50 again comes by considering the density of the air, which is average 1.2, and considering the enthalpy at the reference state at 2500 at 0 degree centigrade, as we have already learned. Now the same formula can be used to calculate outside air latent heat with certain modifications. So that is 50 into cmm of outside air into the specific humidity difference of the outside air. So if the specific humidity of the outside air is omega O and that of the room air is omega R, then the specific humidity difference comes omega O minus omega R. So once these two factors are calculated, you can calculate effective room sensible heat by this formula, and then you can calculate the effective room sensible heat factor, which is equal to effective room sensible heat upon effective room sensible heat plus effective room latent heat. When you get this ERSHF factor, you can again use the scale on the psychrometric chart and fix the point of ERSHF over here, maybe over here, and again draw a line which is passing through this ERSHF point and room air condition like this. Can extend this line up to the saturation line, and the point of intersection of this line with the saturation line is now called as the coil ADP or only ADP. So we'll mark the temperature. This is TADP. So in this way, the apparatus dew point temperature of the cooling coil can be obtained. Now, to obtain the mixed air condition, you have to first calculate the total quantity of the air which is supplied to the room or which is passing over the coil. It is also called as dehumidified air quantity. Now, for this, you can write the effective room sensible heat formula by using the same formula, basic formula, as 0.0204 into the cmm of the total air supplied, which is also called as dehumidified air. So D suffix is used for dehumidified air quantity into the temperature difference. Now the maximum temperature difference as far as ERSHF line is considered, this is ERSHF line. So the maximum temperature difference is this one. So I will take this TR minus TADP. But since the bypass factor of the coil is less than 1, this maximum temperature difference is not achieved. And that's why we have to multiply this by contact factor or 1 minus bypass factor. So this is the actual temperature difference which could be achieved during the process. Rewriting this formula, CMM of the dehumidified air can be calculated like this: ERSH, effective room sensible heat, upon 0.0204 into room temperature minus ADP into 1 minus bypass factor of the coil. Once you get the dehumidified air quantity, you can do the mass balance and calculate the remaining volume flow rate, that is the volume flow rate of the recirculated air. So the mass balance can be explained again with the help of this diagram. So in the air conditioning system, the recirculated air is mixed with the outside air to form the mixed air, and that's why the mass balance can be written like this: mass flow rate of the outside air plus mass flow rate of the recirculated room air is equal to the mass flow rate of the supply air or mass flow rate of the mixed air. Now we are considering the constant density in all the calculations, which is 1.2 kg per meter cube, and that's why for constant density you can also say that the volume flow rate of the outside air plus volume flow rate of the recirculated air is equal to volume flow rate of the mixed air. So I will write here, by mass balance at constant density, CMM of the dehumidified air is equal to CMM of outside air plus CMM of the recirculated room air. So if you know the outside air volume flow rate, and if you calculate the outside, the dehumidified air volume flow rate, you can calculate the volume flow rate of the recirculated room air. So once these factors are calculated, you can fix the condition of mixed air. So again, I will take this picture. Mixed air is formed by the mixing of some percentage of outside air and some percentage of the recirculated air. So M is the result of O and R. So to fix the condition of the mixed air, you can use the formula of adiabatic mixing process, for which can calculate the temperature of the mixed air is equal to the temperature of outside air into CMM of outside air plus the temperature of recirculated air into the CMM of recirculated air upon the total CMM, which is CMMO plus CMMR. So again, I have replaced here mass flow rate by CMM because the density is considered to be constant. So once this temperature is known, you can fix this temperature TM on the DBT temperature line and project that temperature on the line connecting O and R, and you can fix the condition M. Then you can connect this ADP and M to get GSHF line, grand sensible heat factor line, and intersection of this GSHF line and RSHF line will fix the supply air condition. Or you can calculate the temperature of the supply air by using the formula also, For that, you have to consider the bypass factor of the coil. So consider this cooling plus dehumidification process, which starts from M, supposed to be ending at coil ADP, but it actually ends at S. And that's why the bypass factor of the coil is defined as the temperature difference which is not achieved, that is TS minus TADP upon the maximum possible temperature difference which could have been achieved if the bypass factor were 1, and which is this TM minus TADP. Now in this formula, if bypass factor is known, TADP is fixed with the help of ERSHF line, and the temperature of the mixed air is calculated by this formula, we can obtain the tri-bulb temperature of the supply air. And hence we can fix the point S by using this tri-bulb temperature as well. So in this video we have learned how to draw the ERSHF line, how to calculate the outside air sensible heat factor, outside air latent heat, the quantity of the dehumidified air by using this formula, the temperature of the mixed air condition, and how to calculate the supply air temperature, or how to fix the supply air condition with the help of GSHF and RSHF line. So that's all for today's lecture. In the next video, we will learn an illustrative example to explain all the things that we have learned till date. Thank you for listening. Take care. Goodbye.